If you guys ever get married to someone and you have a wedding, the coolest thing you could do is give out these little matchbooks. And then people have matches with your face on it, and they have with your date, that's Carly and Elliot. And they're so cute together, and I just have these matches and gonna light the incense. My name is David Morgan. This is the Music Shed Reaction Series, and we are joined again after a few month hiatus by Danny, who I fucking who I adore, and he's on the camera, and his cute little face is there. Oh, Danny's here. Oh, I don't have to be alone with Howie anymore. Thank God. Anyway, so we got today this really interesting format, which is Matt Garstka, who's a drummer. And what they did was they did their album, and then they took the drums out of the mix. So Matt's going to show us what he did in the studio, what his parts were. So it's like music minus Matt, and then Matt's coming back in to show us. I think that's such a cool idea. Eugene from Ginger mentioned that they played with them on tour, and he got to play with him and jam with him, and he was really excited about that. And his band, Matt's band is Animals as Leaders, and the song's called Tooth and Claw. Let's get to it. Oh my God. Oh. All right. it's laughable how incredible this guy is. Holy shit. He's supposed to be a child prodigy, but talent, prodigy, whatever, that's great. You can't get to do this if you haven't sat behind that drum set and just whatever goes into practicing, which is a lot of things. He's obviously done it because his feet, everything about him, he's relaxed. His technique is flawless and he's just nailing everything. Wow. I've always thought that metal drummers are some of the best drummers ever because they can do anything on the drum set. They're not limited to much. Woo! Oh! And I want to note too, I don't want to forget about this. And by the way, if you don't like my pausing, just skip it because I pause a lot. He's got a lot of, his cymbals are very thick. He can hit them hard and they're not going to ring as much as thinner cymbals. And he's got a lot of deadening, got a lot of moon gels on his drums. So you can hit them hard and they're going to be more dead ring. His drums are not going to be as ringy and neither are his cymbals. So he can hit them hard as he wants and they're not going to have overtones that are going to get in the way of the mix. So that's just something as an engineer, as a studio guy, I pick up on. The tuning of the drums, the way that you treat them and the kind of cymbals that you have really does dictate how the mics are going to pick everything up and how you're going to be able to play. guy's a fucking animal. Huh. There must be a click track here. You know, something else I'm picking up on too here, just the way this guy looks, he just kind of looks like he doesn't look like a rock star. You see this guy on the street, he's like just a regular guy. Some musicians really look like rock stars all the time. And I just like how he's just in like, you know, regular pants and a t-shirt. And he's just like, yeah, I'm just going to come in here and slay this drum part like a fucking maniac and look like a regular guy. There's something I really dig about that. Oh! Ah. Ah. Woo. He's having so much fun. Just being a beast. So, another thing I'm always interested in another blah, 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 thing I'm interested in is how people practiced to learn to get to this level. Everyone's got a different story. Everyone did different things. Everyone had different teachers that taught them different things. Everybody has different... I'm always interested in the story of practicing. So I'm interested now in Matt's story. I'd love to know what he did and what he does. But it's more in the formative years. I don't think as you get, like when you get into a band and you get well known, I don't think you're sitting around like practicing rudiments and stuff, or maybe you are, I don't know. But I mean, I think it's more of just the playing of the songs keeps you in shape. But how'd you get there? Very interesting to me. And if you're a drummer wanting to get to this level, do what he did. It's a good thing. Ah. Oof. Ah. Look how loose he is. Woo! His body is so limber, and his wrists are so limber. And Howie's telling me that this guy studied Latin jazz. The study of jazz music, even if it's not the music that you necessarily want to play in life, the study of Max Roach and Elvin Jones and Art Blakey and Philly Joe Jones and Jimmy Cobb will get you to a technical place that nothing else will. And that's what I have to say. And I don't think there's going to be many women watching this video, so I don't care if you leave that burp in. No, you can leave it within with you. There should be women watching this, and if they're not, you should be if you're a woman and you're not watching this. Look at his wrist. His body's so limber. It looks like magic, but it's not. I mean, it is magic. It becomes magic. Oh, God! He got around that drum set in like 10 milliseconds. Yeah, the release. Let It Go Now. Great song. Woo-hoo! He's got a heart and soul, this guy. China symbol. Oh, my Lord, have mercy on me. Have mercy on my soul. I'm jacked up right now because I love seeing that stuff. Now, it's one thing to be technically great and all that goes with it. And it's one thing to play with heart and soul, but the combination of those two worlds coming together like that makes deep, meaningful art. Art that we're drawn to. There's a very machine-like aspect to what he does, but you can feel his emotions, his heart, his connection to the band, the connection to the music. You feel that in his playing. He means it. He's telling a story. There's something he's communicating. That makes him, in my estimation, a phenomenal artist. I'm so happy Matt Garstka. God, I'm sorry, Matt. I apologize. That was really cool. And I just like that whole concept of let's do the record and let's show people how we played it. So you drummers out there, I'm imagining you are the only guys that are going to be watching this video, or mostly drummers. If you want to play like Matt, and you can play more like him, by not being him, but doing the things that he did. Find out what he did. Find out who he learned from. Find out how much he practiced, what he practiced, what he did, and do some of that. That's going to get you closer to where he is. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I sure did. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the bell icon, and leave comments, because I really enjoy reading them and checking them out. I hope you guys have a very musical day. Peace.